What's going on, you guys? Today we're bringing my dad back on the channel and we're gonna be doing a little overview on his bug. It's a 1967, and do you want to get into it of when you got it?
Yeah, so it was my first car. My grandparents offered me their four-door Audi, it was a 70s Audi, and it was a four-door. And even though I wasn't totally aware of what kind of car I wanted, I knew I didn't want a four-door. So they said, well, how about your mom's bug? So I said, that sounds cool. So at the time, this is the car I learned how to drive on when I was 15. And
you learned on a four-speed?
I learned how to drive on a stick shift. Yeah, and I took my driver's test on this. My mom had it for a couple years before that. She got it because her 356 Porsche was getting things stolen off it, so she didn't like driving it every day anymore. So we got this car. The first color was orange, and it was done with velour orange in black. Black was vinyl interior. And it's funny because the car was white, and my grandfather said, hey, I know a guy that I use to repair my truck, and he does body work and paint and stuff. And the car had been hit in the front, so the front bumper was always tweaked. So my grandpa said, well, this guy wants $500 to paint it and upholster it. So we were like, okay, let's get this guy to do it. And I was a little naive, like I thought it would be perfect, you know. And the paint came out good. Yeah, I mean, it was shiny, and the interior actually came out decent. But, you know, they never fixed things. Like the front end, they just bonded over where that dent was, and like the fender beading, they just painted the whole car.
Well, I guess that's what a $500 paint job gets you, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But nowadays, you couldn't even get anything like that.
So basically, this is like a time capsule from the 80s. It's like a cowbug, and you finished it in the 80s, right?
Yeah. So the first version was finished like in 83, and I lowered it for the first time. I wanted it lowered like when I first got it, because the reason I wanted one of these was because like back then, I would see like just with my mom driving around, I would see like at least like three of them every time we were out driving. It was like they were around, you know? So I was like, wow, what is that? You know, when I first got the car, I subscribed to Hot VW's magazine, and I started like looking at dune buggies and lowered cars, but you know, I wanted to make a cow bug, and you know, I told my mom I wanted to lower it, and even though our family's in the car, she's like, you don't want to lower it, you know, it's your daily car. I didn't lower it for like a year, and I put moon discs on it and did a bunch of stuff, and I hated the way it looked, really, because it wasn't lowered. Like back then, the thing was you wanted your car, at least a bug, like as low as you could get it and still drive it.
So what was like the inspiration for the whole design, and what have you modified? Because I feel like everything's been pretty much touched on this thing.
Like basically on purpose, I kept the vent windows. At that point, one piece window conversion was a popular thing, but old cars had vent wings. It has 66 and earlier trim, and it has cowlick rubber, which gets rid of the chrome strip.
And a four-speed sticker.
Yeah. And then it has a sunken antenna, which was a popular thing like in the probably late 50s of custom cars, not on Volkswagens. Mm-hmm. It has two-piece MP wheels that are original. On the hood, we took off there's usually a raised area here where the emblem is. We took that off, the windshield wiper squirter, I shaved the front hood, the hood handle, and the chrome that's on there, painted the headlight trim rings are painted to match the car. That kind of simulates how old cars used to have shaved headlights. The windshield wipers are painted to match. And if you come around the back, tinted windows were really popular then, so I tinted the windows, but back then they didn't make the film big enough to cover the whole window at once, so there's three pieces. This whole panel is usually stock with different vents, and it was kind of cut up, so I was talking to Scott, and I'm like, hey, what could we do? And he's like, well, why don't we put a louvered panel over that? So we did that, and then we louvered the deck lid to match that. The license plate is usually here in the big light. The exhaust cutouts are filled. And on the front and back, there was overrider holes for the big stock bumpers. Those are filled.
And you got a custom exhaust too, right?
Oh yeah, it's called a dual quiet pack, which it's a S&S, which is like, was the best kind then.
Yeah.
And you can't get it now.
Do you want to pop what do you call it, trunk lid?
Yeah, it's deck lid.
Okay.
But in England, you call it a bonnet or a boot.
But yeah, there's so much subtle detail in everything. Like if you look in different areas, you can tell it's been painted to correspond with all the colors and stuff. It's really cool.
I was gonna say the color was something that is like a 1950s color. But basically, it was like a salmon kind of color. And one of the inspirations for it was one of my aunt's paintings. There's like a color in the painting, mm-hmm. and I always liked that. So anyway, and then on the inside, like the firewall, which is back here, I used plexiglass, cream plexiglass. It matched the wheels and everything. Over time, you know, this is how the engine ended up.
Yeah, but the engine's pretty much stock, right? You just have a dual carb.
Yeah, it has dual carbs, dual Webers, and it's a single port. And it's the same engine that was in it when my mom had it rebuilt. And one thing that's kind of funny is this was my friend Darren and I's idea.
Put louvers on there?
We put louvers in the fan shroud, but they're fake.
And then what do you call this paint up here?
This is called Zolotone. Cars in the 50s, they came this way, like the trunks and stuff.
Oh, I've never noticed that.
Yeah.
It's kind of cool texture.
Yeah.
But then what about the interior? What was the design choices in there? Like the instrument panel and all that?
This is a billet bug dash, and it's an original one. So that's like an 80s like billet thing, like from hot rods, street rods. And in this, it's appropriate, but I wouldn't have wanted that, you know, in a hot rod.
What about the steering wheel?
The steering wheel is an MPGT that, you know, back then my friend found that at a junkyard for like $40, but
it's funny, you got the cassette player. And
yeah, so it's got an Alpine. People stole radios all the time. Alpine was like the then. So anyway, everything's the ashtray shaved on the dash, and there's usually a handle for the passenger to hold on to. That's gone.
But there's not too much built aluminum for being in the 80s, right? Just the mirror.
No, like on the emergency brake, and then the mirror. You know, that was all stuff that there wasn't that many cars then, or bugs that were doing that.
Oh, okay.
My friend Scott, who did the car, he had the same scallops on his car. And then there was one other one done after, but neither of those cars got that much attention. They didn't take them out to shows or anything. And so this car was the first one that really got noticed.
As far as scallops goes, where does that originate from?
Oh, it's like probably from, you know, old planes and old race cars. And mainly like custom cars really did it a lot, like in the late 50s. And you see that a lot on like mild custom cars. But, you know, it makes the car look like it's going fast.
I mean, it's cool that you brought the influence from the previous generation to this. But so when did you actually like finish it? Like what age? Like
it was probably like right before I turned 21. It was just like this.
Crazy. This is one of those cars that has too much sentimental value. That's one of those things you'll never sell.
Yeah, I mean, I'm lucky I have it actually.
It's funny. This is like the only car my dad really, really takes care of, and it's perfect condition. It has a car cover on it all the time, and he actually takes care of it, and it starts up. So it's kind of funny, the contrast of his other cars and this. This is his pride and joy. Don't you dare get a scratch on it. But yeah, do you want to go on a little drive or something and take
it out?
Been in this in a long time, maybe like a year or something.
Really?
Yeah. It's like we filmed with it for a while and then, this reminds me of the original video. Are you gonna pop the clutch?
Yeah.
Just pop the clutch. There we go. That's funny. It's like a little go-kart. I always thought these things were like just super slow and boring, but it has some torque. It's like it puts you back in the seat. It's not like a fast car, but like around town, and I think because how it's so small, it kind of feels fast. Like it's, well, and it has no seatbelts, so it's a little bit more scary. So anything that's kind of fast feels pretty fast.
Yeah, I mean, if you have a big engine in one of these, it really.
Yeah, the drag bugs.
Yeah. Well, you gotta stop here over this big bump.
Yeah, the whole thing with this is it's so low that you have to be careful of everything.
Yeah.
Watch out for this bump.
Oh, I didn't even see that.
Scott Miller,
and then Darren had one, And I met a bunch of other people.
Well, Fish has one too.
Oh yeah, Fish have one too. But, or has one still. But, you know, I met a bunch of people, and then there was probably like five other cow bugs at my high school.
But are these pretty easy cars to work on? Like, would you recommend it to someone for a first car or
something?
Yeah,
I totally would. I mean, I learned so much on this.
But you could still find bugs for pretty affordable, right?
Yeah, it's funny because people that are in a Volkswagen, they complain like the prices are so much. Or I've heard people say that, you know, but whenever I look on OfferUp or Craigslist or eBay, I mean, there's bugs that are totally done that are expensive.
Yeah.
But, you know, I still see, I mean, there's some that, like, total project, but, like, as low as, like, $1,000 or something.
Yeah.
But, like, I think you could get a decent project that's driving for, like, probably $4,000.
That's pretty good. Because, like, Mustangs 5 years ago was so attainable, but now it's starting to get crazy prices. So it's funny because this is, it's manual brakes, manual steering, and it's not even hard at all. It's just because I'm how small it is. It's hilarious.
Yeah, like, it, I mean, you could buy disc brake kits and stuff, but I don't really think it's necessary. But
yeah. Well, I think we're going to keep cruising, you guys, but I think we're going to wrap up the video and just have a nice weekend drive.
Yeah,
but
it's super nice out
today. Yeah, it's a perfect day. But yeah, we'll see you guys in the next video.
Have you ever met Miss Lindy? She's a gal with the bright red hair. Now she stands high from all the rest, you know.